Imagine you're looking to hire a photographer for your next big event. The prices look great and you're ready to go ahead and contact him with the offer, but this shows up as his contact email. Or you're looking for a graphic designer to redesign your website, you meet what seems to be the perfect person for the job, but as soon as they hand you their business card, it has this written on it. Would you still hire these people? Recent studies show that up to 75% of people think that a business isn't credible if their email account isn't professional. Why should a customer take your business seriously if you don't? This means that email addresses like name@gmail.com or Yahoo or Outlook simply won't do it anymore. To look professional and credible, you need an email address that looks something like name@yourwebsite.com. But how do you get an email address like that? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to do this step by step. To have an email address like name@yourwebsite.com, the very first thing you need is, well, a website. More specifically, you need web hosting and a domain name. I'm going to show you how to get these two components right now, but if you already have a domain name and web hosting, you can skip to this part in the video for the actual email tutorial. Start by clicking the first link in the description below. This will take you to a web hosting provider called Hostinger, where you'll be able to register a website name with a huge discount. So I want to show you how to do this as cheap as possible, and Hostinger has plans that start at less than a dollar, so naturally they're a great fit. And using Hostinger, you're not only gonna be able to host your email account, you're also gonna be able to create a website. And if you don't know how to create a website, I have a guide that you can find right here. But for now, let's continue with the actual email tutorial. There are four plans to choose from, but even the cheapest one will do fine. It offers a free website name registration and free professional email services when you buy web hosting for at least 1 year. Now, you'll be able to choose your website name. This is what you'll use to create your professional email account, so choose carefully, because if you go with something like fart111.xyz, your email will look like name@fart111.xyz. Sometimes Hostinger gives you a free .com domain, but at the time of making this video, you'll need to buy a .com separately. If your chosen website name is available, type in the code Emit.Reviews to get the price even lower, and continue with the purchase. Now you should already have web hosting services and a domain name. Let's move over to Hostinger and see how to use their services to create your professional looking email account in like 1 or 2 minutes. Once you have your plan with Hostinger, you should see this screen. This is your Hostinger dashboard. If it's your first time logging in, you might need to set up your account first, but after the initial setup is done, it should pretty much look something like this. To create your professional email address, click on Manage and navigate to the Email Accounts tab. Choose the website name you would like to use, then type in your email name, I'll use info, and think of a password for your new email box. Once you're done, just click Create and you'll be able to access your newly created email by clicking the blue email button. If this is the first time you view this, you'll need to choose which program you want your emails to open up with. I recommend choosing Roundcube, as overall I found it just better to use. With the cheapest Hostinger plan, you'll be able to create one custom email address, but if you're using their mid-tier or high-tier plans, you can create up to 100 different email addresses that you can give out to your employees or just use yourself. Once you've created your business email with Hostinger, there's a slight problem. Every time you want to check your email, now you'll need to log into Hostinger, then go to emails, then go to Roundcube and see if anyone messaged you. And there's even a bigger problem if you have different people that need to access different email boxes at different times. So there's actually a solution to that. But we can use these cryptic looking numbers to actually direct all of your professional emails to your personal Gmail box. So you'll have everything in one place and you'll get notifications on your phone, tablet, watch, etc. Let me show you how to do exactly that. The first thing you'll need to do is go into your Hostinger dashboard and navigate to your email settings. This is where all that information that we need to make this work hides. Keep this tab open for later. Log into your Gmail account, click on this icon right here and click Settings. Go into Accounts and Import, then click Add a Mail Account, type in the mail account that you've created with Hostinger, mine was info@tech2stream.com, choose the POP3 option. Next, type in your email address again and the password you created on Hostinger. For the POP server, use the server Hostinger provides. At the moment, it's pop.hostinger.com and choose the 995 port. Check the first three boxes and click Add Account. Choose Yes, I want to be able to send mail, and click Next again. Here you can choose how other people will see your emails. You can use your name or the name of your company or just whatever. Once you're happy with the name, click Next Step. To get your SMTP server, look at the Hostinger email tab once again. Now, type in the login information for the email box that you've created at Hostinger once again. Choose the port 587 and the TLS encryption. Now, navigate back to your Hostinger account and access your email. Inside, you'll find a mail sent by Google with a link. You'll need to click that link to verify that this email address belongs to you. Once it opens, click Confirm. So now, when you access your Gmail, you'll have two different types of emails. They'll have a tag next to them. You'll see your personal ones without the tag and the business ones with the tag. So you're always gonna be able to separate which of the emails are for you and which are for your business. If you want to write an email using your professional email address, you will be able to select which email you want to use from this drop-down menu. So you can create and link more than one account. And all emails you receive will have this special tag next to them, so you know which of your email addresses it's been sent to. You can sort the mails just for that one email box by clicking here. And that's how you create a professional looking business email and link it with Gmail. My name is Emit and I have loads more tutorials about web hosting and website creation on my channel. So if you're someone that recently started a website or just want to learn more, definitely check it out and I bet you'll find some helpful information there. But for now, good luck with your websites and I'll see you in the next video.